Good day to you, and welcome to another edition of Primetime Sports. I'm Nathan Nair. We start with basketball. Earlier this week, we updated you on the current Sun Belt standings for men's basketball. The Georgia State men's basketball team is on the bubble for making the Sun Belt tournament in 2 weeks. Primetime Sports correspondent David Shealy has more details.
The Sun Belt men's basketball tournament takes place in New Orleans from March 10th through the 13th, and it'll feature the top 8 teams in the Sun Belt Conference. Now, after their loss to Georgia Southern on Tuesday, Georgia State is now ranked 8th in the Sun Belt Conference, meaning they are right above the cutoff line to making the tournament in New Orleans. Just one game behind them is Texas State. Now, Texas State has 5 games remaining, with only one of them against a top 3 Sun Belt team. And in contrast, the Panthers have 3 remaining games against an Appalachian State team who already owns a victory over Georgia State, the number 3 ranked Louisiana Monroe, and the number 2 ranked Louisiana Lafayette. Now, for those wondering, Arkansas Little Rock sits atop the Sun Belt Conference with a comfortable lead and will likely win the regular season title, snapping Georgia State's 2-year run as regular season champs. However, what's more important is that Georgia State may not even get the chance to defend their Sun Belt Conference championship down in New Orleans this year. But we'll have to see with these 3 remaining games. For Primetime Sports, I'm David Shealy.
Thank you, David. Both the men and women will host pivotal games this Saturday against Appalachian State. Staying on the topic of basketball, on Thursday night, the Atlanta Sports Awards were held at the Fox Theater, recognizing individuals and teams who have achieved athletic excellence. Georgia State received 3 nominations. Rashad Milligan has more.
In one of the better years of Atlanta sports history, Georgia State was nominated for 3 awards here at the Atlanta Sports Awards, including Ivy Drake, Ron Hunter, and the Georgia State men's basketball team. Georgia State athletics stood among the best of Atlanta sports in 2015. Legendary voice of the Falcons, Wes Durham, acknowledged some of their best accomplishments.
How about Georgia State, for example, who last March set the country on its ear? With a new favorite in the NCAA tournament. Coach Ron Hunter and his team, they're up for Team of the Year. And Ivy Drake is here tonight. Her parents are here tonight, I believe. Ivy's softball player, Sun Belt Conference Freshman of the Year, and National Freshman of the Year finalist with the Panthers. So congratulations to the folks at the State.
Despite the fact Coach Hunter lost to reigning NBA Coach of the Year Mike Budenholzer, Coach Bud still gave his respect to GSU.
Congratulations to Georgia State. I was watching your games in the tournament, you were on the chair and making big shots. It was fun.
3-time NBA All-Star Paul Millsap won the Athlete of the Year honors. Last summer, Millsap was a free agent but decided to stay in a city he fell in love with.
Yeah, Atlanta's great, man. Before I signed, I recollect on the past 2 years that I had, and Atlanta's been nothing but great to me, so I was excited to be back.
Baseball Hall of Famer John Smoltz was recognized with the Lifetime Achievement Award for his service on and off the field.
Fortunate to be right away integrated with Atlanta Community Food Bank, trying to eliminate hunger. Without food and without the ability, you can't attack any other disease, let alone any other charity. And then, of course, provided the opportunity to go to Children's Healthcare at that time, Scottish Rite, and see this organization impact the world, let alone our own community in our backyard. Being able to see behind the scenes without any camera and then start a Christian school is all things that I never thought when I got traded to the Atlanta Braves would I have an opportunity to embark in.
Smoltz expressed his love for the city of Atlanta as well.
This is where my family's been raised. My kids know everything about the state of Georgia and in the history of my life and the people and communities that I've served. I can't think of a better place, and I want to stay here as long as I possibly can.
Although the team won no awards, Georgia State is still winner, being recognized by the city of Atlanta here in one of the better years of sports in a long time. For Primetime Sports inside of the Fox Theater, I'm Rashad Milligan. Back to you. Play ball.
Thanks, Rashad. After going 1-2 in its season-opening homestand, the Georgia State baseball team traveled to Spartanburg, South Carolina, to take on the Spartans of South Carolina Upstate. Unfortunately, Mother Nature got in the way as the game was rained out. No makeup date has yet been announced, but we will be sure to give you that information as it becomes available. The GSU baseball team will travel back home and host a 4-game set against Coppin State starting Friday. Sticking with the diamond, after starting the season 0-5, the GSU softball team has seen significant improvement back home. Caleb Johnson has more on what has changed for the Lady Panthers.
Weather conditions this week have
simply not been ideal for Panther softball, as we've experienced a lot of rain, but that does not hold the team back from their excitement they experienced this past weekend at the Panther Invitational. Playing four games in 3 days, the Panthers softball team faced skilled competition in Miami, Ohio, Maryland, Mercer, and fifth-ranked Alabama. Coach Kincaid gives us his thoughts.
Well, I saw a lot of improvement from the first weekend to the second weekend. I feel like we competed better, number one. We hit the ball better. We certainly pitched the ball a lot better than we did the first weekend. Our pitching was really strong this weekend.
The team was able to win three out of those four games, which included a walk-off against Maryland by freshman Reagan Morgan and a no-hitter against Miami, Ohio by senior Katie Worley.
I thought it was an awesome job. I told a lot of people that discussed it with me. It was one of those kind of no-hitters that as you're going through it, you really didn't realize that she was throwing a no-hitter. Kind of had to check the book, which is good from a pressure standpoint and from a, you know, a karma standpoint. You don't want to jinx the no-hitter. So it was almost one of those deals where it happened, and I bet you probably three-quarters of the stadium didn't even know she had thrown a no-hitter.
After great improvement at the Panther Invitational, I inquired with Coach Kincaid to see if any changes to the lineup or defensive positioning would occur.
Right now, we're so early in the season. You know, we're doing some different things. It depends on the position. We're giving some people some opportunities. We will continue to do so. Like I tell the kids, if you hit, you're going to play. So we're looking for a couple of spots in our lineup for somebody to step up, get consistent with the at-bat, start putting the ball in play, doing some good things. So we're looking for that. We're still in the process of figuring out, you know, three or four spots in the lineup due to some graduations and some age and stuff like that. So, but we'll continue to do that, and then we'll get set with a lineup probably by the time we start conference play.
These ladies make their way down to Tampa, Florida this weekend as they play in the University of South Florida's tournament. They will play Villanova, Eastern Michigan, and Seton Hall. After speaking with Coach Kincaid, he has no doubt that the team will have great success this weekend, especially building off what they experienced at the Panther Invitational. At Bob Heck Field, for Primetime Sports, I'm Caleb Johnson.
Thank you for tuning in today. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all the latest Georgia State sports news. Like us on Facebook at Primetime Sports, and follow us on Twitter at Prime Sports with a Z. I'm Nathan Nair. Enjoy your week.